So basically, this is basically a show and tell session. So basically how two of us scales technical infrastructure. Why you keep? Okay, so something, I'll start about me. I've been a WordPress plugin developer for most my 12 years. So I developed some of plugins like PageNavy, Post. So you can check it out. So I'm working in Tech in Asia as a tech guy. So basically doing all WordPress related together with Robert. Robert is just joined us like 2 weeks ago, I think. Right? Yeah. So we are still hiring if you are looking for a job, a WordPress related job. Yeah. So I'll start. So if you may not know Willis, so Willis is basically the CEO of Tech in Asia. So he approached me to join Tech in Asia and expand the engineering team. That was roughly in July. So I was still with MiG33 back then, which is also Michael, also was my ex-colleague as well. Then after that, in August, we hired an awesome engineer, Lee Shun. So basically, both of us started work to scale Tech in Asia. So previously, there's a developer right now. There's only one developer in Tech in Asia. So when we took over, it's basically two of us. So previously, we are on DigitalOcean, running on one server. The server will probably crash when it reaches like 500 users. So we are paying like 320 a month for it, which is very expensive. Then when we took over, we basically moved it to SoftLayer because it's free. They give us 10,000 credits for, if you have startup, you can probably apply the Startup Catalyst program. They offer you 10,000 credits a month. Yeah. So right now, Tech in Asia is running on probably 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 servers, one load balancer, three web servers. Because the Catalyst is basically a year program, they extended to next year. So after next year, we told them we probably move out, most likely to AWS, definitely. So when Chris mentioned whatever structure is what we already did plan, but the Elastic Fall system is not out yet, so we can't really do any testing. Hopefully it'll be out soon.
It's in preview now.
Yeah, it's in preview now, yeah. Hopefully it's out for public soon, yeah. So, yeah, we'll be moving to AWS eventually anyway, yeah. So once we move all the server to SoftLayer, the first thing that we should do is basically monitor the server. If you don't monitor the server, there's no way to measure your performance, whether is there any improvement, whether the server is not performing or something like that. So we are using Graphite to monitor all our server stats. So Grafana is basically just a front end for Graphite. And Graphite collects data from CollectD, which is basically a daemon. And this daemon basically collects all the information like memory, RAM, and push to Graphite. So you can see it's just nice charts. So whenever you push something out, you'll know whether it's performing based on the chart. If there's a spike, something must be wrong. So we will normally take a look at it and fix it on the fly. So one of the key features that Chris mentioned is WordPress. When you have multiple servers, one of the common problems is how do you handle user uploaded files? We got about 10 years worth of images in our servers. So basically, we tried using an NES at first, but it was just very painfully slow. So that was before Amazon has Elastic File System. So luckily, one of the common solutions is ClusterFS. So basically, it syncs. You can define mount points and you can sync that particular mount point across all servers. It happens almost instantly. So far, we've been using it for 1 year. It's pretty good. So if you are running your own servers and it's to have multiple web servers, you can take a look at ClusterFS. Yeah, it's pretty good. So we also did some changes to how WordPress works as well. So we moved WordPress used to be in a root folder. So we basically moved further WordPress to a folder on its own, which is called a folder called core. There are two things to this. It's basically it's to prevent automated attacks based on the URLs. And also it's a Git checkout of WordPress in GitHub. So when anybody has an unauthorized modification to WordPress itself, we will know. You can run a cron job that monitors the directory, like Git status, and send you an email every day if there's changes. Because if you have all your files in the root folder without a Git checkout, you will not know what file has been modified by the hackers. Yeah. The other one we did was we HTTPS the whole site, just so that it encrypts sensitive information and give a slightly ranking boost in Google. Yeah. Okay, so WordPress was using 83 plugins when I was there. So we cleaned it, we removed 48 plugins, and we cut down to 35 plugins. So some of the plugins are very, very, very poorly coded. So when you delete a plugin, some plugins doesn't have an uninstall.php to remove the data that they have created, leaving behind a lot of junk data. So data like plugin options, some they add some post meta to your post, comment meta, user meta. So once we fix all that, it took us about a week to fix all that. So literally going through the code, starting the code, find out what options they create and delete manually from the database. So this will be a huge improvement boost. See, when we roll that code out, you can see immediately our database traffic size spike dropped by half, which makes it more efficient. So that's why I say it's important to monitor your servers so that you will roughly know what benefits you get in return. So of course, previously we are using Edgecast, which is really horrible. It's horrible and expensive and doesn't provide a free SSL cert. Since we SSL our own site, our CDN needs to have SSL cert as well. And they charge like, what, $700 just to have an SSL option, US a month. So we decided, screw it. And we go with MaxCDN. Again, it's free for us. We like to bootstrap. So whatever free, we just take. So we are Stack Initial was part of YC. We got a MaxCDN deal. It's literally free for us. So the next, once we solve the server, we solve the plugins. Now next is the team. Okay, the team was also very disappointingly, very poorly coded. It's done by some development studios. There's no proper use of WordPress API. So there's like unnecessary SQL queries all over the place. There's like no central point. You want to debug, you basically have to go through all the codes and find where you're calling. And the CSS and JS is not minified or combined. And one thing I don't like is the features. They comment out the HTML portion of it by using the HTML comments, but they leave the PHP and SQL code inside. So even the feature is not displayed, it's still being loaded. Yeah. So we redesigned the team from scratch, literally just delete away the folder. We talked with the stakeholders, like the editorial team, our product team. We removed unnecessary or unused features. We flattened the whole UI using SVGs and font awesome icons. So of course, JS, we minify it and combine it. And of course, caching. So as long as the information will not change, we normally cache for an hour by default on main cache. Yeah, this is still the old layout that we have. So our previous web stack was basically Apache, PHP, and MySQL, the standard. Just our hobby, I just upgraded it to Nginx HHVM and using MariaDB. For Nginx and HHVM, we noticed quite a lot of difference in terms of speed, in terms of page rendering. It literally cuts from almost a second to about 0.1 second using HHVM and Nginx. For MariaDB and MySQL, personally, I don't really find any much performance improvement. In fact, MariaDB crashes a few times on a few tables, and yeah, so.
Sorry.
Yeah. I'm done already, yeah, just keep it short. So yeah, so basically this is a summary. What we did, we took over, moved the servers, cleaned our plugin, redesigned team, and changed our web stack. Yeah. So for future plans, we have basically plans to, that, as I mentioned earlier, to move to AWS, to make it Dockerize everything. I'm still learning Docker, yeah, so make it everything, yep. Yeah.
Sorry, do you compare with the PHP FVM and HHVM?
It's
different?
HHVM is different. HHVM basically is hip hop compiled code. We now use PHP FVM. We straight away switch it to HHVM from the Apache mod PHP module. We skip the FVM part. Yes. So there's also some tweaking along the way. I mean, performance is an ongoing process. So we tweak the memory, the just-in-time size, and stuff. Then let me see.
But you have problem about search?
Search? Yeah. We haven't done search yet. Search is still basically using Google Custom Search. We have plans to do search probably. It's in the product pipeline, but not so soon. We're still exploring. So normally how I compare, can you see? Okay. So normally how I compare is basically we have this, I'm using this plugin called Query Monitor. So basically, as you can see on the index page, this is our new layout, by the way. So you can see that it only uses like 6 MB and 0.1 second. So before I switch to HHVM, we're getting about like 0.8, 0.9, 1 second just to render the whole page. So HHVM literally cut it down to 0.1.
6 MB is what page size?
I think it's the page rendering size, I think. It's the page rendering size. Including all the database and everything. They got the database, table breakdown, everything. So basically, it's everything all in one. Because we upgrade all in one, so we can't really be sure. But as far as I know, MariaDB has not much improvement.
What gives you that information of the rendering time?
That's a plugin called Query Monitor. Yeah, this one.
I
Correct, you give that information. You break down any PHP error, any AJAX error. It's awesome.
Cool.
Yeah. I totally recommend that. Even on the production side, it's good to use it.
Is that only if you're logged in?
Yes. Yes, you log in. But you also can measure lockout. They allow you to create a cookie. So you can click a button and create a cookie. So you can see the lockout performance as well.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So you know whether some of the queries are caching and some are not.
So you keep the cookie, you log out. And
correct. You can see the offline version of it. Yeah. Query monitor. I like it a lot. See, it's like almost 5-star out of 5. 92 developers, I'm pretty sure. Yeah. Okay, I'm done. Any more questions? Yeah.
Question. It's not something that you covered here, but in WordPress, you often get a lot of revisions. What do you use for cleaning up revisions?
Okay. Shameless plug. I got my own plugin. Which I basically wrote for Tech in Asia actually. So I make it open. So it's called WP Sweep. It cleans up all this information. Not sure if you can see. It cleans up. Let me maximize it. So this is all the things that it cleans up. Revision, auto draft, deleted comments, unapproved comments, spam comments. All this it will clean it up. That's one thing I wrote when I did the cleanup. And I decided to open source it. Yeah.
Are you able to have a production environment and a pre-production environment where you make changes, and then how do you deploy them to production?
We basically make changes to the code and we just git checkout. Normally, when we have, for example, if there's a new database, we normally create it before we deploy the code. So for content changes, we don't really do much content changes. We do content changes on staging. Right. Then after that, we just deploy the code to production. It should work. Right. Yeah. There's another plugin called RAM, but I'm not too sure whether how it works. It does what you mentioned. It's called RAM WordPress. Let me see. Yes, it's this one. It basically does.
So we use Git.
Yeah. Yes, we don't do any changes. Yes. So there's this and another thing called RAM, which is basically does content deployment from staging all the way to production, if I'm not wrong. Yeah, it syncs your RAM. Yes, it's a plugin. I think it's a paid plugin for this. Yeah, it's 249. Yeah. So basically it pushes to staging, it tests and it will syncs to production. I think that's how roughly it works. Didn't really test it. But it's quite a popular plugin. Yeah.
Well, then actually doing it with Git is just as okay, right?
Yeah, it's all right. It's okay. Unless there's... Yeah, it's okay.
So what about if there's changes to the database? Do you point stage at the production database?
No, we basically run the queries on staging first, then we run the exact same query on production.
Right.
Yeah.
And then both
codes? Yeah, both codes, before we deploy the code.
When you create a WP option, you still not have an easy way, right?
No easier. I basically write a script to find out the option and compare it. So for the option, I think we clear from 6,000 rows to 192.
Wow, cool.
Yeah, that's why you see the spike in the queries. Yeah, it took us a long time. Yeah.
So the more options you have in WordPress, the slower. The
correct, because WordPress has for options there's an auto load column which basically set to yes by default. So if let's say you use a lot of options, it will just it's part of your payload in every page. I can't see there's any solution for it because unless there's a central repository like this plugin uses this option name, then you can check against a central database. But if every plugin uses its own option name, there's no way to determine whether or not it's being used without checking the code. Yeah.
Maybe what I can do is you diff the option that you create with the vanilla installation.
Yeah, but some options are because we still have some plugins, existing plugins, so some of them might be still using the options. Their own plugin options. So since we remove 48 plugins, we have to check the code of these 48 plugins to see what options they left behind. Yeah, so it's a very tedious manual job. Yeah. Unfortunately, there's no automated way I can find. Yeah.
But if a plugin is removed,
it will not remove the options.
But how to find?
So basically, when I remove the plugin, I will just see what he have. Normally has a update or add options, I'll find the key name and I just delete directly from the options. Of course, I wrote a script to do it. I wrote a script to do it, so it's much faster. But of course, there's still some human checking involved. It cannot be automated. Yeah.
Any more questions?
Okay, thank you.